I think your Paris are kind of in the mode of, hey, can you go out and take some damage? Yeah, any damage. Just Fielder needs help. It's important. Got to buff Sparkle.
One of your favorite calls really is go feed, tanks. Go feed. I need nano.
It is absolutely how the game is played. Sparkle on a little bit of damage. A little bit of pressure off the deflect. Blade about to be ready. But now Boston trying to take the initiative, but Colorhack slept mid-nano. Tragic. Taken on down. An incredible play coming out from Fielder. Now Sparkle under heavy pressure. Here's the nano. There's the blade. And it's a closed-in corridor. Slices him on up. Four for Sparkle. And Boston is cut on down.
Look at those assists on the blade. You've got nano, supercharger, and damage use from Mercy. I don't even know what that does. It's a lot. It's a lot. I can tell you what. And especially with Halo, he tried to commit the drone, tried to save Color Hex off the sleep, which was a good idea, I think. You know, losing that Tracer would have been painful. But the fact that they don't even get any value out of that drone, and then they don't have it for the blade, that fight's open and shut.
Yep, and he sheaths his blade for good after that. Sparkle now moving to the Tracer. Not gonna top that one on point B, as it turns out. Now Paris working with the momentum again, open up with the Valkyrie. Soon waiting for the Bob, uses it to set the table. Paris has come to dine. However, Bob immediately falls. Boston looking for the opportunity. Colorhex has pulse bomb, and that's been so incredibly dangerous under what he's doing towards the back, under heavy pressure. Hasn't thrown out yet. They lose Jerry, so now it really has to be Colorhex to make the response.
Yeah, Colorhex needs to get something done. He does have that Harmony Orb advantage in the flank fight on the Tracer, but Sparkle's holding his own very, very well. Colorhex can't even get healed, so now he's backing out, and slowly but surely, Paris are working control of this map. Now Sparkle's uncontested, and he comes for Punk.
They've lost Punk, and Colorhex is down. Hanbin gets the punish. And Paris, looking cool, calm, and composed, soon blows him on up. And it's looking like Paris make a statement on point B here on Volskaya.
Sparkle's flexibility continues to be an asset for the Eternal. Beautiful work on the Genji, charging up the blade incredibly fast there. Like, usually we see the Genji blade being that slowing down, the bottleneck, really, in terms of ultimate economy, right? Like, you're waiting for the nano blade combo, but usually it's Genji who's like, oh, give me a while, I need to get behind, I need to poke a little, I need a suicide, just get some blade. But, you know, Sparkle, even in the losing fight, he was already up to 80% blade, so that really enabled his team to hit a timing that I just don't think Boston was ready for.